Jessica Ridgeway is here from Pullman Kitchen and Catering with what I think is just a really wonderful recipe. Because these artichokes are really starting to come in season around here.
They are. They're very much in season right now.
And so what are you going to make for us today?
Today I'm making a blue cheese stuffed artichoke, which is something that I do keep in my case at Pullman Kitchen. It's really great for picnics. You can eat it hot or cold.
Is it an appetizer or an entree?
It's a lovely shared appetizer.
Okay.
However, it can be turned into a full entree. So, and it's very versatile also. You can stuff it with sausage or whatever you
whatever wish. Your dad likes.
Yeah.
So how did you cook your artichoke?
So what I did is I fully submerged this in boiling lemon water.
Okay.
And I cover it with a wet rag and I cook it for about 45 minutes until the heart is very tender.
Okay.
And you can feel it on the bottom.
Yeah.
It'll give.
And did you slice top and bottom off before you did it?
Yes, I do. I slice the top off before I do it and I cook the bottom as well because
Great.
The bottom is edible.
How do you get the heart out?
So what we're going to do right now is I'm going to show you how to remove the choke. You just reach in with your fingers, and of course it's going to be a little difficult.
Well, that's usually how it works.
And then just pull out this.
Okay.
And we're going to take a spoon and we're going to remove the choke from the inside.
So
which
you're just
is,
making a little bowl out of it. Basically.
Exactly. It's like your own personal chip and dip, if you will.
I like it.
So, and then you just remove the hairy and edible part.
Okay.
And that's your choke.
And then you've got the rest of it all kind of ready to go.
Uh-huh. And then everything is ready to go. Usually when I'm at home or in my kitchen at Pullman, I make the filling while this is cooking.
Great.
So what
so
we
your
have
filling
here,
is?
I have approximately a half a cup of ricotta cheese here. I have a little more because it's a larger artichoke.
Okay. And ricotta is the nice light stuff too.
Yeah, it is. Very creamy Italian. I also have blue cheese here, about a quarter of a cup. I have lemon juice, refresh lemon juice. Squeeze it through your hand so that you catch the seeds.
So that's
this
a trick.
Is a nice one, yeah.
Yeah.
And we lost one.
That's all right.
Here, we'll get it.
We're all family here, right?
Okay.
Okay, so you get the little lemon in there.
And then we have garlic, minced garlic. We have fresh chopped basil, fresh thyme. And you just go ahead and give this a nice little mix all together.
And it definitely doesn't take much since your ricotta is so creamy to begin
exactly.
with.
Exactly. It's perfect. Very, very easy recipe.
Oops. Okay, so as you get that
so
all stirred up,
that, then we can take our spoon, just take a nice dollop, stuff it into the center,
load it up. So basically all that filling becomes a dip for your artichoke.
Absolutely.
That's neat.
And you can eat this as is or stick it into a 400 degree oven for about 15 to 20 minutes until the cheese gets really nice and bubbly. And then you just pull off each individual leaf.
And you're ready to go.
And use it as your dip.
And then I suppose you could also
and
just kind of do it, you could do it cold too if you wanted to.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Very versatile. That's beautiful.
There you are.
And it smells great. And here you go, Mike. Here's your sample over here. Just take off one of the leaves, scoop it up, and you're ready to go. So you guys are out at Quarry Ponds, which has been just a crazy success out there from what I hear from people out there. And you have a fun run coming up this Sunday and it goes toward a great cause.
We do. We have it on Father's Day. It's the Leukemia Lymphoma Society. It's a 5K and a 10K mile run. We also have a kids run before. It's a quarter mile run and that one's free. And you can find out all the information on that at quarryponds.com.
And you know, we'll also have a link on KCRA.com as well. So we'll make sure everybody knows how to get involved. And actually on Father's Day, that might be a great thing for dads, take the kids out, wear them out a little bit before the rest
exactly.
of the day, so you can actually relax a
exactly.
little bit.
Exactly. We'll have magic and clowns and a bouncy gymnasium, so all sorts of fun stuff for
now,
the
are
kids.
You a runner? Will you be taking part?
I will not be taking part
be
in the running.
The
I will be feeding, yes.
Feeding everybody.
I'll be manning my Pullman Kitchen station.
Great. So. What's one other thing you might, if you wanted to do this as, say, an entree tonight, what's one other thing you might pair with it?
I would say Italian sausage would be fabulous in it with a little bit of mozzarella.
Would you mix it in
with
the ricotta?
Or to pair with it. Absolutely. It's kind of like a leftover appetizer too, or entree. Anything that you have in your fridge, you know, anything like any sort of meat or cheese or cottage cheese, you know, you can put in here and it's just
perfect.
Wonderful.
Okay, I know you were nervous today. Was that pretty painless?
That was very painless, yeah.
Fair enough. All right, our next news is coming up at noon. And don't forget, we'll have a link for the run on KCRA.com/morningnews. We'll see you again tomorrow.